anything else you guys need, anything or can I access? No, thank you very much.
Whoops, excuse me, curtain call.
Curtain call?
Bobby wants all rights, we tell them.
Okay.
So we put this on the ground?
No, no.
Oh, we don't need you.
I'm going before you guys, so. Lighter up facing the story, Kathy Stanek, maybe I'll come and get her.
It's like your daddy would first make it.
I know.
No.
Thank you.
A reading from the book of Genesis. The Lord God said, "It is not good for the man to be alone. I will make a suitable partner for him." So the Lord God formed out of the ground various wild animals and various birds of the air, and he brought them to the man to see what he would call them. Whatever the man called each of them would be its name. The man gave names to all the cattle, all the birds of the air, and all the wild animals, but none proved to be the suitable partner for the man. So the Lord God cast a deep sleep upon the man, and while he was asleep, he took out one of his ribs and closed up its place with flesh. The Lord God then built up into a woman the rib that he had taken from the man. When he brought her to the man said, "This one, at last, is bone of my bones and flesh of my flesh. This one shall be called woman, for out of her man, this one has been taken." That is why a man leaves his father and mother and clings to his wife, and the two of them become one body. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
A reading from the first letter of Paul to the Corinthians. Set your hearts on the greater gifts. I will show you the way which surpasses all others. If I speak with human tongues and angelic as well, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong, a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and with full knowledge comprehend all mysteries, If I have faith great enough to move mountains, but I have not love, I have nothing. If I give everything I have to feed the poor and hand over my body to be burned, but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind, love is not jealous, it does not put on airs, it is not snobbish. Love is never rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not prone to anger, neither does it brood over injuries. Love does not rejoice in what is wrong, but rejoices with truth. There is no limit to love's forbearance, to its trust, its hope, its power to endure. Love never fails. This is the word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
Also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "None of those who cry out, 'Lord, Lord,' will enter the kingdom of God, but only the one who does the will of my Father in heaven. Anyone who hears my words and puts them into practice is like the wise man who built his house on rock. When the rainy season set in, the torrents came, and the winds blew, and buffeted the house. It did not collapse. It had been solidly set on rock. Anyone who hears my words but does not put them into practice is like the foolish man who built his house on sandy ground. The rains fell, the torrents came, the winds blew and lashed against his house. It collapsed under all this, and was completely ruined." Jesus finished this discourse, left the crowd spellbound by his teaching. The reason was that he taught with authority and not like the scribes and the Pharisees. The Gospel of the Lord. Kindly be seated now, and bride and groom may kneel if they prefer. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. This is indeed a beautiful day, a memorable day, a day that will never be forgotten by Tom and Heidi, because they are about to enter a new chapter in their lives. They're no longer two, but one flesh. What God has joined together, let no man ever put asunder. So I congratulate them both on this beautiful day, And I know they're ready for this beautiful day, and I mean not just beautiful day, but to them, it's a sacred day. It's a day that they've looked forward to, and their love, it's not like a worldly love, but their love is centered on Christ's sacrifice, his teaching. The gospel just read to you was picked out by the bride and groom. When you read about a house being built on rock, any architect knows that if a house isn't built on rock, it's going to fall. The walls will start cracking, the ceiling. It has to have a solid foundation. So the bride and groom, with their architectural experience, picked out that beautiful gospel. I'd never read that one before at a wedding, but it's certainly fitting, because our divine Savior, when he compared the love of bride and groom, he compared it to the love for his church. He said, let the love of bride and groom be like the marriage, like the love of Christ for his church. And as you know, he built his church on a rock, not on sand. He built his church on Peter, the first pope. And Peter means rock. And that church has gone on for 2,000 years. It will continue to go on until our Lord calls an end. Great emperors tried to destroy it, like Napoleon, Mao Zedong in China, Stalin and his successors, and our friend over in Cuba, Castro. They tried to destroy the church. Never will be destroyed, because it's built on a rock solid foundation. Our Lord said to Peter, upon you, Peter, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will never prevail against it. And he who hears you hears me, and he who rejects you rejects me. So Heidi and Tom are anxious to build their marriage on rock, on a solid foundation, the foundation of prayer, sacrifice, true love, hard work. That's what makes a marriage go. And Tom's sister, who read that second reading, mentioned that if you have so great a love as to move a mountain, so great a faith as to move a mountain and have not love, you have nothing. If you give all your money to the poor and have not love, you have nothing. So what is love? What is true love? A lot of people today tell their spouses, I love you, I love you. You know I love you. But sacrifice is not behind it. And if you take sacrifice out of love, there's nothing left. It's just an empty word. That's why so many marriages fail today, because sacrifice is out of the picture. So St. Paul, I think, gives the true picture, that litany of love. I don't have to read it again, but where he said, set your hearts on the greater things, the greater gifts. I will show you the way that surpasses all others. Then he talks about, if I have so much love, so much faith as to move a mountain, have not love, I have nothing. If I give all my money to the poor, have not love, nothing. Then he says, what is true love? And he gives us this little paragraph that tells the whole story of success in marriage. He said, love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not jealous. It does not put on airs. It is not snobbish. Love is never rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not prone to anger. Neither does it brood over injuries. Love does not rejoice in what is wrong, but rejoices with the truth. There is no limit to love's forbearance, to its trust, its hope, its power to endure. This is true love, he says, St. Paul. And then he adds, it never fails. It never fails. And that's the love our Lord came to give us. Whenever our Lord used the word love, you'll recall, he always combined it with sacrifice. He said, if you love me, you'll keep my commandments. Sacrifice. If you love me, you'll deny yourself, take up a cross, and follow me, as the martyrs did. Sacrifice. And this is what it is. It's all about love. And if we're going to live up to our faith today and to live it only in a nominal way, without true love, it'll fail. That's why it fails in so many cases today. So Heidi and Tom, as they prepared for their marriage, were both concerned about this aspect of the rock. We must build our marriage on a rock foundation. Prayer, sacrifice, hard work, giving God the best of your talents. And I know you will. You both will. And I congratulate your parents on both sides for preparing the way for you. If it wasn't for their sacrifice, hard work, perseverance, and giving each other the gift of life, then their marriage would have failed. But it's been a success. And I would say you get all kinds of advice before you're married, as you know, but I'd take a few chapters from both of your parents on sacrifice, teaching, love, how they loved you both, and how they made such a great success of their marriage. You don't have to read any books, you just have to take some examples from their marriage, and your life will go on and on. So that is the importance of true marriage. It's based on sacrifice. Love is a sacred union established by God Himself. And God is the author of marriage. The trouble, the unfortunate thing today is man often tries to make a marriage on his terms. On his terms. They tell God how many children they're going to have. You know, just, we're going to do it this way. We're going to do it that way. It's a rare couple today that comes up and says, Lord, here we are at your disposal in our marriage. We want to be generous. We want to be love-giving on your terms, not ours. You gave us marriage. We want to fulfill it on your beautiful terms. And that brings true peace, happiness, love, genuine love. So this is what we pray for today for Tom and Heidi, that their marriage will be genuine, full of love, but on God's terms, not on the terms of this world, because love, as this world calls it, is nothing. Empty, shallow, it falls apart. If you want to look at the great marriage rate, the divorce, the failures around us, you'll see it's because people became selfish. They wanted a marriage on their terms, not God's terms. When we have a marriage on God's terms, what does it mean? Hard work, sacrifice, continual prayer, and we trust that God will see us through. As the great St. Augustine said, don't worry about your past. Your past is finished. Leave the past to the mercy of God. The present, leave the present to God's love. The future, leave the future to His divine providence. His divine providence. We sometimes forget about that. How many couples worry about, oh, what's going to happen a year from now? Oh, I wonder if I'm going to get sick and all that stuff. We never worry about that. You just do as the saints did, put everything in God's hands. I see the missionaries of charity back here. Tom and Heidi have been so generous with them and helping their poor, and their beloved founder, Mother Teresa, lived that love, that genuine love, of doing the best you can and leaving the rest to the providence of God. And that's why she's been such a successful founder of an order, and why her sisters are so successful and dealing with the poorest of the poor. And that's how marriages begin to work. When they trust God, center their lives on Him and not in this world, and then say, Lord, everything for You, all for You, sweet Jesus, all for You. That brings peace, happiness, and the greatest joy that God can give anyone on this earth. So we pray today, Heidi and Tom, that your marriage will be on that rock foundation. I'm so happy you picked that gospel. And when you celebrate your 25th anniversary and your 50th, you can come together and say, well, we planned on a rock foundation, and our home and marriage has been solid, true, and faithful. So that's our prayer for you today, that God will bless you, continue to bless you, our Blessed Mother too. Remember when our Lord went to that marriage feast of Cana with his apostles? The Blessed Mother was there. The Blessed Mother was there. She should be part of every marriage. Remember, he worked his first public miracle at Mary's request. When they ran short of wine, Mary said, being so kind and thoughtful of the host, they have no wine. First of all, he seemed to give her a rebuke. He said, well, woman, what is that to you and me? We're just guests. She didn't have to ask him a second time. The power of the Blessed Mother. He worked his first miracle on her request. So Heidi and Tom, I know next to Christ, you will put the Blessed Mother in a very important place in your marriage, with the rosary, having trust in her, and she will never let you down. But finally, in the blessing of St. Augustine, may Almighty God give you both a mind to know him, a heart to love him faithfully all the days of your life, and a will to serve him with every talent God has given you. Serve him and him alone. This is St. Augustine's blessing. I hope you'll make it your own. And I know, with the help of God, you'll make this a beautiful marriage. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. Now we will begin the exchange of vows. So we ask the congregation to remain seated and the witnesses to come up next to Tom and Heidi. Thomas, you take Heidi here present for your lawful wife according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church.
I do.
And Heidi, you take Thomas here present for your lawful husband according to the rite of our Holy Mother, the Church.
I do.
I, Thomas, take you, Heidi.
I, Thomas, take you, Heidi.
For my lawful wife.
For my lawful wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
Heidi will say after me. I, Heidi, take you, Thomas.
I, Heidi, take you, Thomas.
For my lawful husband.
For my lawful husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer and for poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
Until death do us part.
Until death do us part.
By the authority of the Church, I ratify and bless this bond of marriage you have contracted. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
And I ask all of you to be witnesses to this holy union which I have just blessed. You now have the blessing of the rings. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. The Lord hear my prayer, let my cry come to you. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, these rings, which we are blessing in your name, so that they who wear them, keeping faith with each other in unbroken loyalty, may ever remain at peace with you according to your will, and may live together always in mutual love, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Now, Tom and Heidi, that you have sealed a truly Christian marriage, now I ask you to give these rings to each other as a sign of your loyalty and faith. Say after me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Heidi, take and wear this ring.
Heidi, take and wear this ring.
As a sign of our marriage vows.
As a sign of our marriage vows.
Good foot. Mm-hmm. Say after me. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thomas, take and wear this ring.
Thomas, take and wear this ring.
As a sign of our marriage vows.
As a sign of our marriage vows.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Another good fit.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
Strengthen, O God, what you have wrought in us from your holy temple, which is in Jerusalem. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Our Father. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Save your servants who trust in you, my God. Send them help, O Lord, from your sanctuary, and sustain them from Zion. Be a tower of strength for them, O Lord, against the attack of the enemy. O Lord, hear my prayer. Let my cry come to you. The Lord be with you and with your spirit. Let us pray. We beg you, Lord, to look upon these your servants, Thomas and Heidi, and graciously to uphold the institution of marriage established by you for the continuation of the human race. They who have been joined together by your authority may remain faithful together by your everlasting help. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Almighty God bless you by the word of his mouth and unite your hearts in the enduring bond of pure love. May you be blessed in your children. May the love that you lavish on them be returned to you 100-fold.
Amen.
May the peace of Christ always dwell in your hearts and in your home. And may you have true friends to stand by you both in joy and in sorrow. May you be ready with help and consolation for all those who come to you in need. May the blessings promised to the compassionate descend in abundance on your own home.
Amen.
You may be blessed in your work and enjoy its fruits. May cares never cause you distress, nor the desire for earthly possessions ever lead you astray. But may your hearts be set on the higher things, for the treasures laid up for you in the life of heaven. May the Lord grant you fullness of years, that you may reap the harvest of a good life. And after you have served him with loyalty in his kingdom on earth, may he take you up into his eternal dominions in heaven. We ask this our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Now I'll ask the parents to light the two candles in preparation for the unity candle. This ritual, my dear friends, is symbolic of the fact that they were once two. Heidi and Tom were two separate people. Now they are one. They are one in marriage. They will light this unity candle now to signify their unity in love, faith, and doing the work God has called them to do. Okay. We will now have the petitions. Lord, we ask you to help us and help Tom and Heidi as we petition for your grace for each one of them to be faithful and true to you all the days of their lives.
After each invocation, please answer, Lord, hear our prayer. For the health and holiness of Pope John Paul and the cardinals and bishops of the church, especially Cardinal Francis George, we pray to the Lord. For all men and women in vocation to God, especially Father Dudley Day and the Missionaries of Charity, that they will have health and spiritual strength to continue their service to God, we pray to the Lord. For all people in this world, that they may have peace and love in their lives, we pray to the Lord. For the deceased members of our families, that they may enjoy the glory of heaven, we pray to the Lord. For all our families and friends, that they may share with Thomas and Heidi many years of their marriage, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We thank you, O Lord, in your graciousness and loving providence of bringing these two wonderful people together in marriage. We ask you to bless them with children, and we pray that their children, we hope they will be many, in your providence, will bless them, help them, and be a true source of glory for them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
You can kneel down. Go back to your places, folks. Yeah. We will now have the presentation of gifts by the mothers, I guess.
Godparents.
Presentation of the gifts. That's it.
And Lord, accept the sacrifice at your hands, the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the power of his name.
O Lord, accept our offering for this new year and help us. Tell us in thy kingdom, by your law and prophets, you have brought them together. Now bless them all the days of their merry life. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Lord, be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your heart.
Lift up the Lord.
Let's give thanks to the Lord our God.
He is right to give him thanks and praise.
Father, all powerful and living God, you will always and ever to give you thanks. By the sacrament of grace, united man and woman, and in the breakable bond of love and peace, you have designed and chaste love of husband and wife, increase both of the human family, of your own family born in baptism. You are the loving Father of the world of nature. You are the loving Father of the new creation of grace. In Christian marriage, you bring together the two orders of creation. Nature's gift of children enriches the world, and your grace enriches all souls in the church. And Christ inspires our angels and all the saints. Praise and worship your glory. May our voices blend with theirs as we join in their and in him. Supper was ended in the cup. Again, he gave him thanks and prayed, gave the cup to his disciples, and said, take this, all of you, and drink it. This is the cup of my blood. One of the new and everlasting covenant will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this, and do this.
Thank you.
together in unity by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church throughout the world. Make us grow in love together with John the Lord, our Pope, Francis, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember our brothers and sisters who have gone to their rest. Hope of rising again, especially the deceased members of Thomas, Stanley, and Titus. Bring them all to the martyr into the light of your presence. Have mercy on us all. Make us worthy to share eternal life. Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, the apostles, with all the saints who have done your will throughout the ages, may we pray you in union with them and give you glory. Your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
Please stand.
Let us pray with confidence to the Father, the words our Savior gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven,
for you live forever and ever.
Amen. and also with them.
Now offer each other a sign of Christ.
Receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed.
here, and I'll bring the chalice back. Here we go. Christ.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Amen. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Father, accept this offering from your whole family and from Tom and Peggy, for whom you now pray. You have brought them to the wedding. Now grant them the gift of the joy of children, a long and happy life together. We ask this of our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God forever. God the Eternal Father, may He keep you in love with each other so that the peace of Christ may stay with you and always be in your home. May your children bless you, your friends console you,
and all men live in peace with you. May you always bear witness to the love of God in this world so that the afflicted and the needy will find in you generous friends and welcome you into the joys of heaven. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, and may his blessing descend upon you and remain forever. I take your bouquet, your blessing, and you both go. Okay, keep your tongue.
Beautiful start. Congratulations.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Father.
Great heart, Peter, that mass.
Thank you.
Be a beautiful marriage. You know,
I know, me too.
So keep up the good work.
Thank you.
Now you turn around and start back, okay?
Okay.
You kiss each other first. Come on. That's always fun.
Thank you. delightful.
Thank you.
Yeah, where is the spread? Is that allowed anymore?
Oh.
Oh, I'm sorry. You want
to get
it anyway.
Yeah, get the cork.
All right. We need a couple more glasses.
Here, you take this side.
Need another one?
Pour them.
Let's go.
Pour them a glass.
There you go. Take
a picture.
Get a glass.
Okay, you gotta take a picture.
I need that. I think we're gonna need that.
Ready.
What's the wedding party table name?
Caroline, this is that's where
I'll be. Can I have a copy? Okay.
You know, our been doing a lot of traveling and still the same.
Ladies and gentlemen, if I can have your attention, please. I am proud and honored to introduce to you some important people without whom none of us would be here this evening. If you could welcome them all with a warm round of applause as they enter. First of all, a nice round of applause as we welcome the parents of our bride. Please welcome Mr. and Mrs. John and Kathy Waltenberger. Mr. and Mrs. Arnold and Joanne Pins. Four gentlemen without whom we would have all been lost today. Our ushers, let's have a nice hand for Mr. Sean Heaton, Mr. Dave Duffy, Mr. Todd Carlson, and Mr. Mike Bresman. The most important day of one's life is not complete without your best friends nearby. That's why we welcome the members of our bridal party, our bridesmaids and groomsmen. A nice hand for Mrs. Mary Michelle Krupka and Mr. Bill Waltenberger. Ms. Deanne Langenfeld and Mr. Jim Waltenberger. Ms. Lisa Simonellick and the first of our best men, Mr. John Pins. Our lovely maid of honor and our second best man, Ms. Katie Waltenberger, escorted by Mr. Mike Pins. Small people with very big jobs. Today, let's have a hand for our flower girl, Ms. Madeline Merritt, and our junior bridesmaid, Ms. Katie Pins. And now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd ask you all to rise and join me as we welcome Mr. and Mrs. Heidi and Thomas Pins.
Softball games, and he introduced her as the girl that he carpooled with. Tom's not exactly a 9-to-5 type of guy. He's the kind of guy who works from, wakes up at about 11, goes to work at noon, and works till about midnight. Did all through college. He's still doing it since then. At our softball game, Tom and I have been playing together for probably a dozen years, and that night he had about 6 errors. He has probably more errors than he's had in all the time we played together, so we knew there was something going on. We knew that he thought Heidi was special and made him a little nervous. You know, Tom's one of those guys, anybody who knows him well, he's one of those half dozen guys you meet in your life that he's something special. He's one of those people who...
Yeah.
Does he owe you money? It's really hard to describe unless you know him, but he's one of those guys that he's always doing something for other people, and even I don't know a lot of times, you know, where he is. You know, there's been times where I've been out of town, and he's been down in St. Louis when I've been in St. Louis, and he's down there driving some of the nuns down there to help him out, or he's been, you know, helping him out at their home, and it's not something that he ever talks about. He just does it because that's the way he is. So I think anybody who knows him at all knows he's something special.
Well, I really can't put it in any better words than John just did. Tom and Heidi are two very special people, and I really didn't get a chance to appreciate that until the ride up from Shedd Aquarium. We tried to take some photographs down the shed, but the weather wasn't quite conducive in any case. It was really the first chance that that I had to see the two of them together. And all I can say is very impressive. These are two people that clearly are very much deeply in love, and I'm very excited for both of them. I anticipate great things, and I think many children. I won't go into any details in terms of what happened during that ride. It's clear to me that they want me to stop talking. They want us to eat, the festivities to be done with, and for us to move on. So in lieu of that, I think we'll cut things short. Just a toast. Tom and Heidi, we wish you the best, and God bless you.
Before we all take a meal together, if I can ask Father Dave to give us a few words of prayer and thanksgiving before dinner, Father.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we thank you, Lord, and your loving providence for bringing these two lovely people together and helping them to fall in love deeply and prepare for marriage your way. Not the ways of the world, but your way. And we know that you will bless them and help them to do everything according to your plan, which always brings us peace and true happiness, no other way. So we thank you, Lord, for arranging that they meet, that they fell in love, and this beautiful day today when they pledge their love to each other in the solemn nuptial ceremony. We ask you to help them in the days ahead, the years ahead, to be true witnesses to your teaching. We pray that they will win others over to your way by their example, by their words, and by their very life. We ask you to bless them with children, and we pray that their children will return their love 100-fold. We thank you for their parents who guided them so carefully in all their beautiful homes to prepare them for this important day, which is necessary. A good home is so important, a training for a good marriage. Bless us, O Lord, in these thy gifts, which you are about to receive in your bounty of Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you very much, Father. Enjoy your dinner.
Well, Heidi and Tom, we want to say that we are very, very proud of you. And Tom, we're very impressed with you. And we think you'll make a fine son-in-law. May you have a long, happy, and healthy life together. Good luck.
Hi. Oh my God. I wish you the best of luck and happiness and everything that goes with it.
Heidi's my goddaughter, and I've just enjoyed watching her grow up. She's such a lady. Her laugh is so special. It's unrecognizable. I'm glad that I could be part of the wedding, and I hope that she has a fantastic future that I know she would. And I just love what the priest said today, where how
right,
a rock, and they're both architects, and I know they're going to have a lovely life, and I wish them the best.
To Tom and Heidi, both of you, it's good having you in the family, Heidi, and God bless both of you. I thought the wedding today was beautiful. You come from a wonderful family, and we're glad to have you in ours, and I hope you have a great honeymoon. God bless both of you.
Tom, Heidi, congratulations. Aunt Pam and I, and Melissa and Denise, really are so happy for both of you. In the meantime, have some fun too. Melissa really wishes she could have been here with you today, but she couldn't come back because of her work. But our family is all for you, and we hope you have fun in Austria. Bring back some Schnitzelbank for us, okay? Have a great time. Many congratulations.
Welcome to the family.
Welcome to the family.
And Heidi.
I just want to apologize. I'm sorry you had to put your wedding off a week since I was in Rome, La Roma. So I just want to apologize and thank you for giving me the chance to attend by postponing it a week. Thank you very much. Enjoy Italia.
Heidi and Thomas, I'm extremely happy for you. Make a great couple. I hope you have a great vacation and love and happiness the rest of your life.
One, two, three.
Hello, Marta. Hello, Father. Here I am at Camp Granada. This is Heidi, God Almighty. Just can't wait until tonight.
Hi, guys.
Hope your Dave and Buster shorts work tonight.
Come on, come on, bye, bye, bye. Ants go marching one by one, the little one starts to suck his thumb. And they all go marching down to the ground to get out of the rain.
Katie and the boys have a few words that they would like to share with us.
So I'm going to take the walk here. Yeah. Can you hand y'all a microphone? Can we get here? Good evening. Thank you, everybody, for coming tonight. I'm the oldest brother, and I'm monitoring tonight's main honor speech. And so at this point, I'd like to turn over to the man of honor, my beautiful younger sister, Katie.
Hello, everybody.
I just wanted to thank Heidi and Thomas for letting me participate on this wonderful day. And I love you guys both. And I'm also glad that I have a new older brother, Thomas, who can overpower Jimmy. Father, he's stronger than Jimmy. I'm sure that Heidi's happy too.
What are we
going to
do with
Billy?
Hey.
Billy's in his own room. He's in his own room. But I just wanted to wish you guys the best of luck and that I'm glad to see you both happy.
Unfortunately for my younger siblings, Thomas and I made a pact before the wedding. Now it's just me, we're a team. It's being antagonizing for my younger brother. First, I'd start by saying a few words about Thomas. He's truly one of the kindest people I've ever met, one of the genuine good people. I'm very happy that maybe they could find someone like him of his character. Heidi and I go way back. We've been roommates for 2 years, which if anyone knows some of the stories from high school, you would have actually thought that one of us not going to be in here tonight. Heidi's actually an excellent roommate. She's a tough girl. She's a very sweet girl. She's very beautiful today. At this point in time, I'd like to hand the microphone over to our cleanup hitter, the politician of the family, Bill.
I just want to start out and thank all of you for coming tonight. It does my heart good to see so many people who care about both Heidi and Thomas. All our friends from back home and family, and all Thomas's friends and family, I think it's very special that you came out tonight and shared this evening with them. I also want to say that I'm very proud of the two of them for the volunteer work that they've done at the homeless shelters. I think it's very easy for all of us to forget about the good fortune we have. We've been blessed with so many loving family and friends, and I think it's important that we learn from the example that they're setting for us, taking time out of their lives to go down and help those that are less fortunate. I think we can all learn from that example. And I just think that we need to give them a round of applause for that.
So, at this point in time, I'd like to propose a toast. Heidi Thomas, a lifetime of love and happiness.
Cheers.
Oh, that was great, guys.
Oh,
that was really good.
Yeah. Yeah. The gingerbread is much taller, sweeter, more beautiful. The tradition of breaking bread continues. We're cutting away.
We gotta be holding the knife. Yeah. Did we get a knife?
Did we use it? So we get.
Somebody bringing a knife?
Okay, put the knife on the table. Look at each other. Look at each other. Look, yes.
Thank you.
important than the cutting of the cake is the sharing of the cake with one another. Give a nice round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. Thomas and Heidi.
Fathers in the background, dads over here too, okay? Denise is going to start it with the whole group.
With Aunt Joanne. With Maya.
Okay. Tom and Heidi sitting in a tree. K-I-S-S-I-N-G. First comes love, then comes marriage, then comes the baby and the baby carriage.
Now, the 90s, there's another table over the corner that had some ideas. They were sort of tricking, but I have to over them. Okay. The Mondrews, the Rockers, and the Pistons, and the Michigan, and the Stanley Cadet. Bill?
When I retire, they're smiling. Is that a good enough film to start?
How about the Notre Dame fight song? I'm sure there's no Peru fans
in here. Go ahead. Here, go ahead.
How about cheer for another day?
You'll bring the whiskey.
I can't get this table going over here.
How about going here to figure out
nobody?
Yeah. Sound like
fight song. Oh, this table is quiet now.
Live, table 10. When we last left Tom and Heidi at Camp Granada. Me.
Hello, friends. Hello, family. As you know, Thomas is dandy. He's not a pig like all the others. He's so much better than his brothers.
We don't mean to
rip his siblings. As you can tell, we're Rudyard Kiplings. We can't sing or write, we reckon. We're just trying to get Tom and Heidi neckin'.
Had a chance to join and witness as Thomas and Heidi became husband and wife. We saw their first kiss as husband and wife, and yes, even their first meal as husband and wife. And now they've invited us to join in their first dance as husband and wife. For this moment, they chose a song by the Reverend Mr. Al Green. Ladies and gentlemen, here are Thomas and Heidi, and Let's Stay Together.
Thank you.
Mr. and Mrs. Thomas and Heidi Pink. There they are. Give them a nice round of applause. And now I'm going to ask Thomas to execute the hardest task he's going to have to execute all night long. I'm going to ask you to give up your bride just for a couple of minutes to the other most important man in her life. If you would hand her off, and if we get Mr. Waltenberger to come on over here and take his little girl on the dance floor. For these special minutes with Dad, Heidi chose a song by Natalie and Nat King Cole. Ladies and gentlemen, Unforgettable. Somebody you've been looking at for the last couple of hours. By the hand, walk them on up. Feel free to sing in their ear. We started with Mr. Christopher.
Looking for a little so long, and your cheeks so soft. There is nothing for me but to love you, and the way you look to me.
Thank you. Keep, no, keep the applause going. Come on, she's almost here. There you go. There you go. Have some flowers. All right. Now, ladies, just so you know, a few simple rules before we begin. Heidi's going to turn around and face me. She's got a throw. She's not allowed to aim. For each of you, number one, biting, scratching, and kicking are encouraged. All right? We have a record of this. And number two, and all too important, I looked immediately at you when I say this. Okay? If it does come to you, you must catch it. You're not allowed to turn around and run the other way. Got it?
Got it.
All right. All right. Turn around, then. You gotta face this way. You don't get to aim. What do you think this is? This is fate. All right, you ready?
Okay.
Here we go. One, two, three! So, no, it bounced off your arm. I'm sorry, you're there. Okay, Heidi, it's your call. We gonna call this young lady a recipient?
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. Congratulations. All right, Katie, we're gonna try and hook you up with a guy. All right, just go hang out for a couple of minutes. Gentlemen, your dear pal Thomas is about to partake in one of the most important missions of his career. Any words of wisdom?
Go for it.
All right, then. All right, Thomas, you're on.
Hey, we need more guys.
Give me a break. All right, give him a nice round of applause. Well done, sir. Well done. Boys, same rules as the ladies, all right? Give it everything you got, and remember, if it does come to you, you may not run the other way. You must catch it. All right? Thomas is not allowed to face you guys. He's not allowed to aim. This is fate. Alright. Here we go. Count of three. One, two, three! Alright! Good grab! Hold on, we need a picture. Don't run off. No.
I'm married, I can't take
it. Cheated. Okay, somebody take acceptance of that garter and come over here for a picture.
President!
Get over here.
Got it. Come on, give it to me.
He's still trying to give it away. Okay, let's... There she is. Heidi, you're in a picture. Come here.
I'm so uncomfortable.
Thank you.
Stop you back on your way. It's fun to stay at the Ready to win. Friends, and I know that this is the right guy for you, and you guys have a great time together, and we'd love to spend more time with you and have you visit us, and we'd love to visit you too, and never forget the best of the memories in high school and stuff, and seeing you in architecture school, just stressing out, but
well, we really think you're a great couple, and we're so happy for you that you found each other. Seems like the stars came together and there was a perfect match made in heaven. And Thomas, anytime you want a Bombay Sapphire engine, come on over. We've got one for you.
We love you guys.
Bye.
Hey Heidi, hey Thomas. We just want to say hello and congratulations. We're very happy for both of you. And we left a little present in your room, so we hope you enjoy it. But have a great wedding night and a wonderful honeymoon and a great life. We love you.
And if you didn't hear any of that, because I don't think she spoke up enough, congratulations and best wishes.
Some people wind up.